number 29.
Oh, baby!
Her first Rumble from NXT, the center of the universe, Tiffany Stratton.
Royal Rumble, it's Tiffy time!
The former NXT Women's Champion, Tiffany Stratton going up high.
From the top.
And Stratton taking out everybody with a swanton.
Now she's holding her own with one of the biggest stars of the last decade.
And plenty Becky Lynch. And now Stratton and Roxanne Perez, two of NXT's finest, going after one another.
Ooh.
And Perez sent down by Stratton. And what a number, number 29, to enter for Tiffany.
Liv loves to tell the world to watch me. Liv would love nothing more than the whole world to watch her at WrestleMania in the main event.
I know Pat and I had one of the most incredible moments of our career, the night that Liv Morgan cashed in Money in the Bank to become the SmackDown Women's Champion.
Uh-oh.
And Roxanne eliminated by Tiffany Stratton. Becky eliminated as well, so we are now down to five. And Stratton, Belair, and Morgan out on the apron.
Stratton fighting with everything
she's got. What a code breaker. And Stratton now hanging on to Bianca's brain.
No way.
Tiffany Stratton trying to eliminate Bianca Belair. Bailey now eliminates both. We're down to three.
And I've also signed a SmackDown contract. Where's my applause?
Girl, I'm sorry.
It's great for you.
You know what? I'm not afraid to step up to the baddest woman in WWE. And you're gonna remember me.
Oh!
Whoa, ladies, stop.
You gonna make me stand on business tonight, right? Yeah?
Yes,
bet.
Right.
Heck no!
You're nothing compared to me.
You're
nothing, Mia.
Oh no!
No payback for you there. And that was a rookie error. I hate saying that about Tiffany Stratton, but talking smack to someone like Meechin before you get the job finished is always going to come back and bite you.
No doubt about it. Meechin just letting those fists fly. Rocking and rolling, Tiffany Stratton back and forth across the ring. Drop kick on the money.
Welcome to the big time, Tiffy.
Neck breaker by Meechin. Tiffany Stratton all out of sorts, trying to find respite in the corner.
Tiffany finding out it's just a higher level every time you step up that ladder. Oh,
wow. Double knees to the face. Cover here by Meechin, and Stratton wisely realizing she is just inches away from the bottom rope.
Superb wherewithal from Tiffany Stratton after taking a beating there, keeping her hopes alive on this SmackDown debut. Okay.
Tiffany Stratton has been incredibly impressive, but in danger of defeat courtesy of Meechin, and a bit of a shortcut by Stratton, effective nonetheless. Look at this, we saw this in the Royal Rumble match. Alabama Slam stacked up high. That could do it, no.
Well, Tiffany Stratton is a top-level competitive gymnast, a former member of Team USA. You saw a small glimpse of that athletic ability there. This woman is capable of doing things no other woman in this division can.
Meechin utilizing her well-educated feet, kick to the body and a boot to the jaw of Stratton. Stratton bulldozing Meechin back into the turnbuckle. Once again, muscling Meechin up. Oh, this could be it, Wade.
This is it, this is it.
Prettiest moonsault ever. Welcome to SmackDown, Tiffany.
Yeah, guys, I'm here with Friday Night SmackDown newcomer Tiffany Stratton. Congratulations on the last several days. You had an amazing showing at the Royal Rumble, which I know you're very proud of. You signed your Friday Night SmackDown contract. You did what you said you're going to do. You defeated Meechan on SmackDown. You've got to be on top of the world right now.
I mean, we all know it's only a matter of time before Tiffy Time went to Raw or SmackDown. And SmackDown happened to be that lucky brand. And not only did I prove to everybody back at home and to everyone in the locker room that I belong here, and whether they like it or not, they're going to be seeing a lot more of the center of the universe. Toodles.
Oh, we might be in for a treat. Stratton was thinking about the prettiest moonsault ever, but Vega able to stop it for the moment.
Well, Vega knew that was coming. 619 to the shin. I haven't seen that before.
Very unique counter by Vega from the second rope. Meteora! Shoulders down! And not enough just yet. Stratton wisely rolling to the outside, taking a moment to compose herself.
Don't judge a book by its cover when it comes to Tiffany Stratton. She is built double tough.
Wade, you can see the frustration building on the face of Zelina Vega. Legado del Fantasma with the best seats in the house. Electra Lopez taking time to...
Oh, no!
Lopez was giving Zelina a tongue-lashing. Vega had heard enough.
Well, Vega needs to remember the task in hand here, which is Elimination Chamber qualification.
But Vega got caught. Look at this power from Stratton. Wade, what time is it?
Tiffy time!
Prettiest moonsault ever. Tiffany Stratton is going to the Elimination Chamber.
Me win my qualification match, and you know, I'm a little new around here, and I don't really know how the chamber match works. Do I pin you first, or do I pin you first, or vice versa?
Oh, girl, See, I've actually won the chamber match before, so yeah, you ain't talking to me.
Yeah, you actually seem really confused. I think Zelina hit you a little bit too hard. Wait, okay, do you need anything?
I know we are not doing this during my big business meeting.
Yeah, she's talking to you.
No, but she's not.
Ladies. Tiffany, not the time or the place. Thank you very much.
I'll see you ladies at the chamber match. Toodles.
Yeah, girl. Chamber.
So respectfully, if I have to, I'll pin you. You, and definitely you. To get to WrestleMania, because you can't spell WrestleMania without E-S-T.
Bianca, girl, you are so last year. No. Like, literally, you peaked like last year.
Girl. Girl, you just got here like, what, Tuesday? So you barely even go here.
I just got here. I really don't know.
Oh, and here we go. Morgan and Stratton. Why wait till Saturday? Bianca Belair is in heels. Well, was. Or is.
Is. Holy.
Oh, no. Nia Jax. The irresistible force. Nia Jax taking out everybody. Samoa drop to Naomi. Now turning her attention to Morgan and Stratton.
It's Tiffy time.
A lot of these women forgetting Nia Jax. All we're talking about Rhea Ripley, but Nia Jax! Maybe the women's champion comes Saturday.
But at the same time, let's be honest, Wade. The women in the locker
room. Here we go,
Corey. Oh, prettiest moonsault ever, but rolled through. Double stop by Morgan. The women on the roster
not taking too kindly to the attitude of Tiffany Stratton.
Yeah, but that same, oh!
Unique offense by Morgan.
That same attitude from Tiffany Stratton was there during her entire time in NXT. She faced the same issues with the locker room. She conquered them all, won the NXT Women's Champion, and owned that division.
How sweet do you think it would be for Tiffany Stratton to get her hands on Becky Lynch, the woman who took the NXT Championship from Stratton?
Oh man, a lot of bad blood still exists there, but everywhere you look inside that chamber, there will be women with agendas.
Here we go! Stacking up Morgan. Right now, Tiffany Stratton's agenda is to break Liv Morgan in half, and even the EST felt the impact on that.
Well, I feel like the disrespect that is often thrown towards Liv Morgan is simply too great. She has proven time and again she can get the job done in the biggest moments. Who could ever forget her winning the Money in the Bank ladder match back in 2022? Certainly up there with the biggest names in this division.
Stratton again looking to position Liv Morgan for the prettiest moonsault ever. Liv up just in time.
Tiffany Stratton now realizing it's a very different level of competition here on SmackDown.
Powerbomb stacks Stratton.
Stratton trying her best to cling onto those ropes to prevent that slam there from Liv Morgan, but failing in the process.
Oh my goodness, face first into our announce desk goes Liv Morgan.
Oh,
and Stratton disrespecting Belair. The EST's seen enough. Watch Morgan from behind. O'Connor Rose, shoulders are down.
Yeah, referee just too late, and in the collision, the EST taken out inadvertently.
Stratton stacks Morgan. Tiffany Stratton steals a win.
Here is her winner, Tiffany Stratton. Making her way to the ring from Prior Lake, Minnesota, Tiffany Stratton!
Might have something to do with the international dateline, Michael Cole, but can you tell me what time it is?
Yeah, it's Tiffany time. Now, Tiffany Stratton beat Zelina Vega to qualify for this Elimination Chamber match tonight. She picked up a big victory over Liv Morgan last night on Friday Night SmackDown. She could be a dark horse in this event.
I completely agree with you, Cole. Tiffany Stratton to this point has absolutely lived up to the hype, but we're gonna find out a lot about Tiffany in this particular matchup, because inside the chamber, there is no hype, just flesh and steel.
And Tiffany Stratton will enter the fray.
Tonight, the center of the universe can be found in Perth, Australia.
You saw the rankings on top of the pods of the WWE 2K video game rankings. Always controversial. Tiffany Stratton with a 79, and I don't think she'd be happy with that. And Stratton now showing off.
Yeah, Tiffany Stratton extremely early on in her career here in WWE, but wasting no time making an impact of her own.
Yeah, showing off that Team USA gymnastics background. Cover on Becky. Hook of the leg and a kick out by Lynch. And now Naomi, who's got a kick out as well.
Lynch may have just damaged Tiffany's arm irreparably.
And now Liv Morgan.
Stomping Tiffy through the mat.
And now Naomi up on top of a pod.
Oh my
God! The sunset flip powerbomb from the top of the pod. Stratton.
Cover.
Takes advantage.
Tiffany stole it. What a brilliant decision. Oh, no, no, no. Lynch looking for the manhandle slam. This will be the end of Tiffy time.
Tiffany Stratton able to counter, though. And now Stratton shoves Lynch into Raquel off the top of the pod. And what does Stratton do now? You don't think.
Look, I certainly hope not. No, 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 no.
Stratton launches herself off the pod.
A swanton takes out the field.
Tiffany, tonight you competed in your very first Elimination Chamber match. I know the result wasn't what you hoped for, but surprisingly, most of Australia seemed to be in your corner.
Obviously, Australia has great taste, I have to say. But maybe if they would have cheered a little bit louder, I actually would have won.
You're blaming Australia?
Yeah.
Okay, well, what's next for Tiffany Stratton?
I'm going to fly my pretty little self home back to the United States, in first class, of course, and I'm going to show up next Friday and show everybody why I am the center of the WWE universe. Toodles.
Toodles.
As we've seen before from Naomi, she is built.
Oh, my God.
Double tough can keep bouncing
back. Tiffany's out. Naomi into the cover. This one's got to be over.
Yeah, and now you're starting to see some of the issues with Tiffany's relative lack of experience when someone like Naomi comes along who has this broad scope of offense that Tiffany simply hasn't come across before can be problematic.
Look at these women exchanging rights. Naomi getting the best of this exchange. I'm starting to believe Tiffany Stratton's skull must be made out of concrete after being able to stand up after that pile driver on the apron.
Yeah, oh! Replying with
cover.
That spine buster. Digging deep, remembering it is WrestleMania season, the time to catch the eye of management. Get yourself on that card that is rapidly starting to fill up. And now right in the drop zone, but Tiffy simply too quick for Naomi.
Smart strategy, but I don't know if Tiffany's safe just yet. Oh, Stratton went to the eyes, raking at the eyes of Naomi. Our official did not see it happen. And Stratton taking advantage.
Yeah, incredibly smart move there by Tiffany Stratton. And right in the drop zone is Naomi.
Boom! The prettiest moonsault ever.
Here is your winner, Tiffany Stratton.
Yeah, guys, I'm here with Tiffany Stratton. And Tiffany, you had an impressive victory over a veteran like Naomi. You continue to prove yourself week after week since you've been to SmackDown that you belong here. Do you feel like you've made your mark here so far?
Kayla, I told everyone from the very beginning that they were going to remember me. And look at me now. I'm Miss Undefeated and on my way to becoming the greatest of all time because that is what the center of the universe does.
Well,
Kayla,
you know.
Do you happen to know the time? It's Tiffy time. Toodles.
Oh. It's Tiffy time, everybody.
What do you got?
Watch your hair. Let's go. Come on, watch your hair.
Wait, I would dare say that the more confident Tiffany Stratton becomes, yes, that is possible, the more dangerous she becomes in the WWE ring.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. People are really sitting up.
Hooks the leg, cover.
And taking notice because newcomers like Tiffany Stratton are simply not supposed to be this good this quickly. Remember, it's only been a couple of years since Tiffany Stratton's first match in NXT in her entire career. She's already looking like she is going to be a dominant force, taking on veterans like Meechin.
In the opinion of many, it's the ruthlessness of Tiffany Stratton that is her best asset. We're going to put Meechin away, but member of the OC, Meechin, trying to turn the tides back in her favor with a vertical suplex. Meechin thinking about the Styles clash, but I think that hesitation is going to cost her. Oh, did it ever.
You almost get a sense Meechin was staring for some approval at the entranceway from AJ Styles, but wait a second.
It's okay to stare at this, the prettiest moonsault ever. What a win for Tiffany Stratton.
Here is your winner, Tiffany Stratton.
Honestly, I thought it was a little rude how I wasn't given an opportunity at WrestleMania. I mean, who better than the center of the universe herself to shine on the grandest stage of them all? And you're clearly building to some sort of open challenge, and well, I accept because it is Tiffy time.
a little embarrassing. It's very nice to meet you, Tiffany. I'm sorry to burst your bubble, but I was not offering an open challenge. Actually, I actually had somebody in mind. So sorry. And this person, I've been very excited to get back in the ring with. This person is a legend in the making. This person made a big return at the Royal Rumble, and that is the one and only Naomi.
So, Naomi? We were in the middle of something.
Oh,
and by the way, I already beat you.
You'd have tried me on the wrong night, little girl. Sure, you've beaten me before. But here's what you don't know. I have earned every single thing that I have gotten here in the WWE, and I don't plan on stopping now. So, Bae, I can't accept your challenge just yet. Because first, I want to take on Clueless Tiffany right here and right now.
Oh, reversed in the midair, hooks the leg. And Stratton survives again.
Yes, Stratton, though, is living dangerously. That was incredibly close to the three count. Tiffany Stratton hurting it in a big way, barely knows where she's at, perhaps bleeding from the nose at this point.
And on the other side of the coin, you've got Naomi, who just took a moment to catch her breath, regain her composure, and hopefully finish the job. Looking for the O'Connor roll.
Double stomp by Stratton. Hook to the leg. Wow.
This is where Tiffany, as the less experienced star, starts questioning where the hell do I have to go from here. This is the kind of deep waters on SmackDown Tiffany is not yet used to. Naomi's been here and done that, though.
A great counter by Stratton. Naomi in trouble.
Alabama slam.
Just took a moment to warn Bayley that she's coming her way. Prettiest moonsault ever. Naomi out of the way. Stratton able to recover. Double leg by Naomi. Jackknife pin. Oh, wow!
Here is your winner, Naomi!
Well, Naomi in danger of being counted out.
Tiffany Stratton! The center of the universe. The woman who Naomi defeated last week to earn this opportunity. Playing spoiler.
Well, Tiffany Stratton believed last week she should have been handed that opportunity. And obviously did not take losing well.
Well, the center of the universe reminding Naomi and Bayley.
Well, toodles to that championship defense.
Get over here.
Stratton throwing both Bayley and Naomi back inside of the ring. This is going to force a no contest decision on the title matchup, which is unfortunate for Naomi. What the hell does Tiffany Stratton think she's doing?
This is a rookie who believes she is owed everything by the world. And if it won't give it to us, she's gonna take it.
Prettiest moonsault ever, times two.
What did I say?
It is indeed Tiffy time.
The EST and Jade Cargill not happy with tonight's proceedings.
Megan Scott, unfortunately, I had to cut my party plans short.
Who invited you to a party?
Well, actually, the Street Profits did. And, well, be that as it may, let's focus on a topic that I think you would prefer, and that topic is you. Tonight on SmackDown, we had a WWE Women's Championship match between Bayley and Naomi, ultra competitive, and then you decided to interfere in the match. You drop Bayley, you drop Naomi, and now everybody's asking the same question. Why?
You know what, Byron? I have my sights set on the WWE Women's Championship. And last week when Naomi beat me, it was a fluke. She didn't deserve to be in that match, and that's why I did what I did. I just had a Tiffany epiphany. Who better than the center of the universe herself to win the WWE Women's Championship? Oh, I just love the sound of that. Toodles!
The Tiffany epiphany. That's quite the take on things.
I'm so proud to be the champion right now, so I'm excited to see who does this. Oh, and it looks like my girl Naomi.
Patella to the cheekbone, maybe the nose.
Naomi got all.
Oh!
What the?
Nia Jax! Nia just ripped Bayley out of her commentary seat, and the irresistible force is wrecking the WWE Women's Champion.
This match is continuing. We've got Bedlam at ringside thanks to the Annihilator.
What? Naomi finally realized what was going on and tried to come to the aid of Bayley. Referee Dan Engler just threw this match out. It's going to be a no contest. Nia flattens Bayley again.
Here's what happens when you are the champion.
Nia Jax wasting absolutely no time, just minutes after being drafted to Friday Night SmackDown. Nia staking her claim to the women's division.
Stratton avoided the worst of it. He was happy to embellish on the damage already caused.
And the disrespect continues, complete disregard for the veterans in this business, for the women who laid the groundwork that she follows. Tiffany Stratton cares about one thing and one thing only, herself. Prettiest moonsault ever times two.
Stratton and of course Naomi just missed out on the opportunity to become number one contender.
Look who showed up, Naomi, who faces Tiffany Stratton Saturday at Backlash along with Bayley, and Naomi is here.
She said, change your clocks. It ain't Tiffany time.
And Tiffany and Naomi beat the hell out of each other at ringside. Nia and Liv Morgan continue their match in the ring.
It is yet again Tiffany time.
Oh, and Tiffany bounced right off the announce table by Naomi.
It is no longer Tiffany time.
Face first off the apron. Naomi, big kick to Stratton.
Glow time!
Nia Jax not happy, knocking Naomi off the apron.
Stratton sends Bayley into the neutral turnbuckle. Stratton flexing her otherworldly athletic abilities. Snapmares Bayley over. Look out, here comes the Alabama slam. Bayley is stacked. Naomi takes down Asuka.
Referee now lost complete control of this one.
It is chaos. This is a melee. Bayley to belly.
Scorpion kick by Dakota Kai. And look at the power of the EST KOD.
Damage control, Tiffany Stratton, I hate to have to pull you all aside after a disappointing loss tonight on SmackDown, but Kabuki Warriors, I have to ask this question. You lost tonight in the eight-woman tag. If you lose tomorrow...
Byron with the disrespect! All the time, huh? Lose tonight? It's already out of our minds.
okay? There's a reason why the Kabuki Warriors have held the tag titles for as long as they have, and people forget Asuka and what she's done. People forget Kairi and what she's done, okay? So tomorrow, they are going to retain these titles and continue to elevate them like only the Kabuki Warriors can. God.
So here's your Kabuki noise, ready for Kabuki Warriors!
Okay, thanks, ladies. Tiffany, on a hopefully more positive note, you were also in that match, obviously, but perhaps tonight was a chance for you to scout your opponents tomorrow in both Naomi and Bayley.
I was this close, Byron, to pinning Bayley, and then Naomi had to so rudely insert herself into our business. And guess what? Come tomorrow night when the Tiffy title is on the line, I am coming out on the Tiffy top, and I'm taking the title away from Bayley. Toodles!
A lot of aggression. A lot of aggression.
Michael Cole, as unpopular as this opinion may be, Tiffany Stratton has got to be considered a dark horse to leave France as the new WWE Women's Champion.
Yeah, but Corey, let's think about what Tiffany Stratton has accomplished over her only 2.5 years so far here in WWE. And Stratton gonna show off a little bit here. Oh, and back elbow caught Naomi. Now Naomi ducked into the timekeeper's area, and that's one way to make it 1-on-1 for a bit.
That's a smart strategy, but here's where the inexperience comes
what
in.
Tiffany
Stratton has Bayley all alone in the ring. Stratton needs to be focused on the task at hand.
And then she's gonna pay for it. Bayley with a suicide dive. Great call, Graves.
That could have made all the difference. Stratton's best title opportunity may have just gone up in smoke because of that very same ego that brought her here.
And Bayley is just feeding off the WWE fans tonight as she points at her WWE Women's Championship. A kick by Naomi, drops the champ momentarily. Naomi now off the barricade. Bayley's in trouble. Naomi's gonna fly. Tiffy does not want to be up there.
Naomi forcing Stratton to change her plans.
Naomi showing off her power.
High angle, shoulders down.
Kick out at two.
But Naomi looking to transition right into the submission hold.
And Naomi trying to tap Tiffany here. If she does, she'll win the championship. Stratton trying to get out of trouble. Tiffany's in trouble. Is she going to tap out? Bayley with an elbow from the top rope, breaking things up.
The champion with the cover hooks the leg.
And a kick out by Naomi.
And here we go again. Look at this. Back into the Alabama Slam, but reversed. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, look out.
Oh, my God. Right on the announce table. Spine first.
Stratton just broke Naomi in half. And Bayley may be in for a similar fate.
Now to the French announce table. Stratton with Bayley up. And Bayley spine first on the table. Tiffany Stratton is dominating. Will it indeed be Tiffy time here tonight?
Stratton's got daylight. She's got both opponents down. We've seen this in the past. If Stratton is looking for the double prettiest moonsault ever, we're going to have a new champion.
And I think she is. Stratton glancing back, looking to climb up to the top rope. Oh, and they moved out of the way.
Stratton rolled through.
Naomi, though, double team neck breaker. Almost a 1D.
So, Tiffany, I know you're not in a celebratory mood tonight. I know you wanted to leave Backlash as the WWE Women's Champion, but I want to take a step back, if you will, and look at the big picture when it comes to your career. 3 years ago was the first time you ever stepped inside a WWE ring, and tonight you were in the ring in Lyon, France, of all places, against two of the most decorated women in our division, and you held your own, and you came that close to becoming champion. What did that moment mean to you?
Like you said, Byron, 3 years ago, I set foot for the very first time in a WWE ring. And every single opportunity that I got, I made the absolute most of it. And look where I am 3 years later. I am competing in France. I compete in Australia. I'm competing for the WWE Women's Champion against the champion and a former champion. Let's just imagine where I'm going to be in the next 3 years.
You did mention Australia, which leads me to my next question. We had an inkling history might repeat itself, and it did. You had nearly 12,000 fans out there chanting Tiffy time multiple times. I asked you this on the kickoff show, and I'm going to ask you again because we're still trying to figure it out. Why do people love you so much?
You know, I've actually been trying to figure that out myself. Honestly, like, it really keeps me up at night. I just had a Tiffany epiphany. They love me because why wouldn't they love me? I'm beautiful, I'm athletic, I can do all the flips, all the cool stuff, and did I say that I'm beautiful? Of course you already knew that. Toodles.
And there's the Tiffany we all know and love.
And now it's Bianca Belair raining down heavy rights on Stratton, who escapes and again looks to use the braid of Belair.
The old-fashioned tug of war that the EST won.
Stratton gets a face full of turnbuckle for her troubles. And the EST giving chase, but again, Stratton utilizing the braid. Oh! And Bianca's leg caught in the ropes. This could prove catastrophic for the EST's Queen of the Ring dreams.
Yeah, twisting that previously damaged knee in a horrible fashion. That wasn't playing up earlier today, it certainly is now, and that is a game-changing moment in this match.
Stratton in complete control. Is the EST outgunned tonight? Bianca takes great pride in that honor. Shoulders down. To represent the WWE Universe in the strongest way possible. Double underhook. Up we go. Great counter by Stratton. Shoulders down. Tiffany's going to head to the next round. Countered by Belair. And a sickening thud with the forearm across the chest. Bianca has Stratton up. KOD, but the sure-footed Stratton able to avoid the impact.
That Olympic level gymnastic skills of Stratton keeping her in the fight for now.
Big double stomp into the cover. Bit of a lackadaisical cover by Tiffany Stratton. Stratton utilizing her otherworldly athleticism to no avail. Waist lock by Belair. Big German suplex. Scrambling into the cover is Bianca. Prettiest moonsault ever.
Ready to pounce is Belair. Take two on the KOD.
On one good leg. KOD.
Nadia! Obviously, besides myself, you are my favorite to win Queen of the Ring, and as Queen of the Ring, I can't help but notice that there are so many people gunning for you, and I just want to let you know that I have your back. The Queen of the Ring and the Princess of the Ring, no one could stop us. Just think about it. Toodles!
Jade Cargill is out cold, so now is your chance. Shock the world!
Moonsault by the Poison Pixie, knees up from Stratton. Could it be Tiffy time? Prettiest moonsault ever! Stratton's going to Money in the Bank.
Here is your winner, Tiffany Stratton!
Tiffany Stratton continuing to make waves.
Tonight on SmackDown, the woman to my left overcame both Candice LeRae and Jade Cargill to qualify for her first Women's Money in the Bank ladder match.
Do you happen to know the time? It doesn't matter, because it's Tiffy time. And I mean, are we even surprised that I qualified tonight? I am the center of the universe. Everything goes my way in my world. And tonight, I proved that I'm the best woman in the division. And next week, I'm going to do it again when I become Tiffy in the Bank. Toodles.
Toodles. Tiffy in the Bank. In 1 week's time, that could become a reality.
Chelsea's almost there! Tiffany Stratton as well!
Chelsea's gonna do it.
Chelsea's got the kill, and she had it on her momentarily.
Tiffany started shaking the ladder.
And now Tiffany Stratton and Chelsea Green face to face, top of the ladder, high above the ring.
Chelsea Green through the damn tables.
And ladies and gentlemen, it is Tiffany Ty, Miss Money in the Bank.
Here is your winner.
That was one of the most incredible, one of the most physical, one of the most uncomfortable, one of the greatest Money in the Bank ladder matches I've ever witnessed.
No argument from me, Cole. What a battle. What an effort by all six women.
Shouldn't we be praising the highlights of the night? I mean, the center of the universe just won Tiffy in the Bank. Trishy, I think you should say a little something to me. You know what? It doesn't matter. Social media is already praising me in this match, and Tiffy in the Bank is going viral.
You know, I was gonna say congratulations, but instead I'm gonna offer you a little piece of advice. Don't get too ahead of yourself. And don't be too arrogant, because it's what happens once you cash that in that can determine if you'll be a future Hall of Famer like me or just another flash in the pan. Toodles.
Aw, Trish, isn't it a little sad looking at that ring, knowing that Trishy time is no longer? And my time, Tiffy time that is, has just begun. Toodles.
Said toodles.
You did.
Said that, so.
The audacity, Trish. Right? The audacity. Toodles. Cole, Corey. Congratulations to Tiffany. All due respect, but no way to treat a Hall of Famer.
Excuse me, Tiffany. What just happened with you and Trish Stratus?
Well, clearly, Trishy never wished me congratulations, and you know what? Neither did you.
Congratulations, Tiffany, on winning the Money in the Bank ladder match and the contract and briefcase. What exactly are your plans for cashing in?
What, do you think I'm stupid? I'm not going to tell you that.
Ugh. If you're not going to tell me your plans, then can you tell me if you're going to Tiffanize your briefcase?
I sure am. I might turn it pink. I might rhinestone it. I might add an extra strap to carry it around like a purse. You'll have to wait and see. But for right now, toodles.
But you blew my mind with that interaction with Trish Stratus, a real mother versus daughter match. So are you ready to face Trish Stratus? And do you think you have what it takes to defeat the GOAT, Trish Stratus?
Listen, those are two different, completely different generations. And Trishy time, she is one of my idols in professional wrestling. And I am ready to get in the ring with the GOAT.
Let me play devil's advocate. Let's say I slip on a banana peel at SummerSlam and you do beat me.
I will
beat you. Tiffy, what's gonna happen then? You gonna cash in on old Nia Jax here? Because we all know she has a little PTSD from the last time you got
captured.
Bailey, I'm well aware you're no longer the hugger I injured before your SummerSlam match in 2017. What are you now, BBL Bailey? I don't know what you're trying to prove by playing divide and conquer with me and Tiffany. I have no problem with Tiffany. She's my personal little Barbie doll. But you, Bailey, you're not a toy. You're my victim. And at SummerSlam, I'm gonna victimize you.
The champ is hard enough. Bailey went to fire a right-handed Nia and got trapped by Stratton, and now the champion's outnumbered.
Well, this is the worst place Bailey could ever find herself, two on one.
Wait a second! That's Mee Tin with a kendo stick.
Mee Tin, who has made a target of Nia Jax of late, braver than most.
The WWE Women's Champion is in big trouble come SummerSlam, and here comes Bayley.
Well, Bayley's trying to get a licks in early, but missed Money in the Bank with that briefcase, the ultimate equalizer.
This is not where Bayley wants to be. Thunderous headbutt from Bayley, SummerSlam challenger.
The problem with being the champ in WWE, you're constantly a moving target for women like the Queen of the Ring and Miss Money in the Bank.
Oh my goodness, and here comes the wrecking ball. Bayley may be a moving target as WWE Women's Champion, Wade, but it looks like there are two superstars with incredibly heavy artillery who have Bayley locked directly in their sights.
A little over 3 weeks at SummerSlam, Bayley. This is your future.
Queen Nia Jax and Miss Money in the Bank operating on Tiffy time tonight. On Friday Night SmackDown.
What a fearsome unit. Hold on.
Wait. You don't think.
I do.
No, you.
It's happening!
Stratton's gonna cash in!
Wasting no time. What?
Tiffany was maybe just trying to run through it once to experience what it's going to feel like someday.
They call that a dress rehearsal. Get a few reps in, just a little practice go. Nia does not look happy.
Hey! Wait a minute. Oh, look who's here! The WWE Women's Champion, Bayley! And Nia Jax just sent it to the timekeeper's area.
Queen Nia, Bayley's opponent at SummerSlam for the WWE Women's Championship.
Bayley's got the Money in the Bank briefcase.
Queen Nia just got flattened.
The champ just tattooed Nia with the Money in the Bank briefcase. Bayley's unhinged.
Lost her mind. Bayley, that is an accessory for Tiffy.
Watches out, bad news from behind. Mee Tin stacks up Stratton. Mee Tin wins.
Here is your winner, Mee Tin.
What a shocking turn of events for Tiffany Stratton and Nia Jax. The arrival of Bayley and the destruction of Tiffy's coveted Money in the Bank briefcase.
Two women who got humiliated last week on SmackDown by Mee Tin and Bayley.
Oh, what's the point of a sneak attack, a jump start before the match? We have a scheduled tag team match ready to happen.
Jax and Tiffany Stratton are not here for a victory. They are here to punish two women who made them look like fools last week.
Here comes Bayley, the WWE Women's Champion, who will collide with Queen Nia Jax at SummerSlam. But right now, Bayley's got to check on her partner. There's no way Mee Tin's going to be able to compete.
Well, she's never needed that kendo stick more than right now.
What the hell, bro?
Queen Nia Jax, Miss Money in the Bank, Tiffany Stratton, understandably scurrying away from the scene of the crime. But is the damage already done?
The Queen of the Ring, Mee Tin out of the way. Enziguri tag made, Bayley's legal.
The Queen of the Ring is rocked.
Bayley hit the running knee, trying to position Nia Jax.
Bayley trying to get this finished as quickly as possible. This might be your big moment.
Elbow connect, cover by the champion. And Stratton at the last possible fraction of a second.
I don't know if Stratton made it or if Queen Nia kicked out, but it was a millisecond either way. Jax is in big trouble here.
Nia now looking for a Samoan drop, but Bayley again coming to the aid of Mee Chin. Referee Dan Engler trying to get the illegal competitor Mee Chin out of the ring. And the Money in the Bank briefcase right in the mug.
The bandaged up briefcase, and it may soon be a bandaged up Bayley.
Annihilator.
And queen of the ring, Nia Jax!
You know what? Bayley may have dismantled my briefcase, but guess what? I beat the champion tonight. I beat Bayley. Doesn't that mean I should be champion? Ugh, get out of my face.
Surprise for you.
Oh my gosh.
For being the perfect princess to my queen, got you your own custom briefcase. Don't forget who got this for you, because tomorrow if you decide to cash in, you will no longer be princess and queen, and you will just have to answer to me.
Okay, I promise. Thank you, queen.
You're welcome.
Wow,
isn't that adorable?
I mean, personally, I would change the font, upgrade the crystals, and make it like a pale green color, but that's just like me making it cute, right?
Yeah.
See, because before you pushed me off the ladder so rudely, I was designing my own Money in the Bank briefcase. P, don't you think touching Chelsea looks so much better than tacky time?
You know what, Chelsea? Green is definitely not your color. Doodles!
The face.
Bayley looking to deliver the flying elbow! Cover on Nia to retain the title! And Nia kicked out at two!
Extremely close, far too close for comfort. But this matchup continues. What did you just say about this place getting crazy?
This Money in the Bank! Tiffany Stratton and running down to the ring with a ref in tow!
Nia made Tiffany promise not to do this!
There have been two cash-ins in the history of SummerSlam, and Tiffany looked like she wants to make it a third, but Bayley knocks her off the apron. And Bayley now taking out Nia, stacking her up, kick out by Jax! Bayley looking to take advantage of Tiffany rushing out here.
The champion just delivering a barrage of offense to a down challenger. Here comes Bayley again, off the ropes.
Nia Jax, the power bomb. And I don't think Nia Jax is done there yet. Bayley up and down again. And now dragging the carcass to the corner. Jax from the second rope with an annihilator.
Oh, no. Oh, God.
And for good measure, a second one by the Queen of the Ring, who now calls herself champion.
Here is your winner, and new WWE Women's Champion, Nia Jax.
WWE Universe, bend the knee. There is only one, Queen Nia Jax, who is now WWE Women's Champion.
For the second time in her career. And now Tiffany Stratton out here celebrating with Nia.
Could it have been a plan all along?
Perhaps.
Between Queen Nia and her Princess Tiffy?
To provide a distraction to allow Nia to turn the momentum and the tables in this match.
I need pink balloons, a pink carpet. Why aren't you writing this down? Everything needs to be perfect for Queen Nia's championship celebration next week. You know what? I got it. It's fine. Just leave. Ugh.
Yes, girl! Yes, girl! Yes, girl, this party sounds so good. Mwah-mwah. We've got the pink in all its pizzazz. We would have maybe gone for like a fuchsia, but that's, you know, it's just me.
Tiffy, if you have the time, I'm wondering maybe when we win the tag team championships, you could plan our party. No, wait. Pretty Deadly, the musical. We're casting.
We are casting.
What's your vocal range?
So we kind of need like Sabrina Carpenter, mm-hmm. but with the joy of One Direction, and we
and
need to feel
pain.
That joy.
I gotta go, guys. I'm busy.
But the pain of... Why is there always pain?
Wow. Aren't you the prettiest little princess at the state fair? So are those your plans for Nia's celebration? Because if the party's anything like this abysmal outfit, you should let the classy one take over.
Don't you have a ladder to fall off of?
Well, Nia doesn't even like pink.
And if you were really our friend, you'd know that.
That's right. We see right through all this tacky time. You are clearly looking to cash in on Miss Nia. This is all a ploy.
Yeah, Fibbony.
Oh my God, Chelsea! You are so right! You really are arrogant, oblivious, and you're even delusional! You really can't do it all, Chels! Toodles!
And now, not only am I your queen of the ring, I am your new WWE Women's Champion! And everyone in that locker room better bow down to me. Well, and what better way to start than with you, Tiffy?
You want me to bow down?
Yeah, I want you to bow down, Tiffy.
Right now?
Right now.
Okay, absolutely. You know what? I'm so glad we are all on the same page here because that's actually why I brought Pretty Deadly here. So first they're gonna sing you a little song and then we are all gonna bow down to you, Queen Nia, because men should bow down too. Boys, come on.
Well, with permission from Princess Tiffany, we have for you a brand new hit song. So for all of you eagerly awaiting and wanting a sneak peek, we've got it. Pretty Deadly,
the musical.
Yes, boy!
So without further ado, we give to you Ode to the Queen.
Love it already, bad news.
It's not our first time kneeling before a queen, but you're the prettiest one that we've ever seen. Admiring you, well, that's a no-brainer. Cleopatra, meet Meghan Trainor. What would you be, Bailey? Melt. Now let's accessorize around the belt,
because we're your biggest fans
when you annihilate your great dance break. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hey! That's great.
Wait a second!
Oh!
Me Chin from behind with a kendo stick!
I was enjoying that!
Me Chin has been a thorn in the side of Queen Nia for weeks now. And Me Chin looking to get the last laugh at the expense of the WWE Women's Champion.
Well, Me Chin did promise Bayley she'd be back for some retribution against Queen Nia, and I guess it starts here.
Oh, no, boy. Pretty Deadly being worn out by Me Chin.
The show's been ruined.
Can Meechin capitalize?
Whoa!
What? Oh my God! This Money in the Bank! Tiffany Stratton making a beeline to the ring with the contract in hand!
No, she's out here to help Nia Jax, as we said earlier!
Well, no disqualification, so perfectly legal. Oh, wait, wait. I think Tiffany just realized Nia's down and out. I think Tiffany... Oh, she just got caught red-handed. I think she was going to cash in. Nia Jax said, what the hell are you doing? And now, back on the attack on Meechan.
There was no cash in. There was no attempt at cash in.
And now Nia placed into the cover. Meechan gets the shoulder up.
Stop stirring the pot, Cole. Tiffany Stratton came down to help Nia Jax. And luck has completely turned this match on the head. Oh,
oh, wait a minute. Going for the prettiest moonsault ever. And look who's back for the first time since SummerSlam. Bailey's here!
Well, Meechan is up. Bailey's back for months. Now it's time for a little payback.
Tiffany Stratton's distraction cost Bailey the championship at SummerSlam. And Bailey hasn't forgotten. And Bailey now is back, rolling with this Money in the Bank.